Good afternoon. My name is Ann Smith, and I'm honored to serve as president of the board of directors of Olympia's own Capital City Chorus and Chorale, directed by Daniel Colgan and Vicki Jardine-Tobin. On behalf of the board and all the singers, it's my pleasure to welcome you all to our fifth season.
So, you can hear me, correct?
Good!
All right. Welcome to our afternoon concert. This is our first matinee. We had a concert last night. I wanted to tell you just a little bit about this next piece. Gaudete is a text originating really from medieval times. One of the first published pieces was from about 1582. It is actually originally Swedish. We don't always think of our texts as coming from Sweden, but this group of texts did. Several of these texts eventually ended up being well-known English carols, like Good King Wenceslas, which you will hear later in the program, and other very, very familiar carols. So this Gaudete means to rejoice and give thanks and make merry, and what a wonderful time this is being together and celebrating. So the interesting thing about this Gaudete, however, is that it's got a 21st century twist in that we have percussion with it. Michael Engelhardt really did a little bit of a different thing here, and we have an agogo, we have a Volkswagen brake drum, we have a covered tom, We have a cymbal-covered snare drum and a conga off to the side. So it's really a fun, fresh approach to Gaudete.
Oh,
I just want to make sure it's on. Yes, thank you. I just wanted to say one thing about this next piece. By the way, it is our third birthday today. We have been around now for 3 years, and we're very excited that we have grown to this size. It's very fun for us all. This next piece is called Wexford Carol. It is a traditional carol, but it's arranged in a way that highlights our sense of urgency to try to keep the peace, to be together, to work together, to remember our blessings, but also how we struggle constantly against the strife of life. And so it's a wonderful, very deep, meaningful rendition of Wexford Carol by Laura Hawley, who is a Canadian, just over the border into Vancouver. She's a wonderful composer. This is Wexford Carol by Laura Hawley.
Consider well.
please, would you join us in our carol for the day, or for the first time today, is O Come All Ye Faithful. You'll find it on page 11 in your program. Please stand and join us.
Oh, Yeah. a quick note before we sing our next piece. I just want to mention one of our former singers, David Dunn. David was a bass two who sang with us since our inception in 2018. Around this time last year, he commented to me the fact that we always sing an Omanium Mysterium, and they're always his favorite. Well, David passed away this September, and we would like to dedicate this performance of this year's Omanium to his memory.
Amen.
The next piece we will sing is the Gloria from Amy Beach's Grand Mass in E flat. Amy Marcy Cheney Beach was born in 1867. She was a New Englander, and she was also the first American woman to compose a symphony and have it published. It was also premiered by the Boston Symphony Orchestra. She was quite prolific during her lifetime and enjoyed a very successful career as a composer. Despite her fame, after her death in 1944, she was largely neglected until the end of the 20th century. She's rather made a comeback into the spotlight since then, especially with the current renewed interest in female composers. Boston even has an Amy Beach Day, which they celebrate every year on September 5th. The Gloria movement from this mass today was composed in 1892, so relatively early in her career. This mass actually was partially responsible for helping to launch her career at the time. If you want to know more about her, you can find a 55-minute long documentary on PBS that was just released last year, and it's a very, very good snapshot of a very interesting person. She only uses a part of the full Gloria text today, and it is the part that's said to have been sung by the angels at Christ's birth.
Thank you.
We will now take a 11 or 12 minute intermission. So we hope to see you afterwards. And please allow the choir to exit before you get up for intermission. Thank you so much. Welcome back. Please turn to page 11 and join us for Joy to the World.
Thank you.
The next piece we will sing is a very delicate setting of an ancient text, and it's written by the youngest composer on our program tonight, Duncan Toomey, who is a California-based composer, was born in 1994. Toomey recently won the 2023 American Prize for Composers of Short Choral Works. After that, we will be presenting a typical Handel double choir piece. We tend to hear a lot of Handel this time of year, but it's usually parts of the Messiah, or his tune for Joy to the World, which we got to sing earlier in the program. This, however, is from Solomon, composed in 1748, 7 years after the Messiah. This chorus comes about halfway through the third act of Solomon and was written in the typical Handel oratorio style as a dialogue between two choirs. And this is a format that he uses rarely in the Messiah, but very frequently in his other oratorios. So just for a frame of reference, choir one, where are you? And choir two? There you go.
Oh.
As we set up for our last couple few pieces, I just want to say a big thank you to all of our sponsors and all of our donors tonight. In particular, I'd like to name our titular sponsors, the Park Foundation of Thurston County, the Jocelyn Dome Fund, Funeral Alternatives of Washington, Tanya Hennen and the Coho team of Windermere Agents, and lastly, individuals Armin and Susan Baumgartel and Zane and Ann Smith. And just a heads up, that green form that was on the inside of your program. On one side, there is indeed a donor form if you would like to be on this list and would like a tax receipt for that. But the other side is just an email form list. So if you did not get an email about the concert today, feel free to fill that out. I said 5 to 6 on the green form, but we really only send 3 or 4 emails a year about our performances, and we would love for you to be on that list. So feel free to fill out either or both sides of that form if you like. Lastly, I'd like to thank our helpers and the house team today. I would love to thank our house managers, Jana Cox and Nick Colgan, as well as our ushers at D. Glenn. And lastly, our audiovisual crew back there. We have Shelley Lively, Dennis Longnecker, and Jim Tobin.
Thank you.
no cleanup confetti is a new invention. I'd like to invite members of the chorale forward at this time, and the audience is welcome to join us in singing our closer, if you like, on page 11, Hark the Herald.